Hello, my lovelies. Welcome to my channel. Here we are doing the monthly reading for all zodiac signs. This is going to be for Leo, Sun, Moon, Rising, and Venus. Let's get right into your reading, Leo. Let's see what Spirit has for you guys for this month of November 2020. All right. Whoa, Leo. We're starting off with the Two of Cups. Whoa. Exciting news. We have the Knight of Pentacles, your strength card here. Very, very activated. With the Four of Cups, we have the King of Pentacles. We have the Page of Pentacles. Wow. Knight of Cups. The Wheel of Fortune. The Five of Cups. And the Three. The Three of Cups. Okay. All right, Leos, this month of November, it's all about opportunity, seizing the moment in regards to love and romance. All right, so you have the Two of Cups here. There is an individual, someone that you may be dealing with, currently dealing with, or someone that you are aware is interested in you, but you may not feel them as much as they're feeling you. With the Knight of Pentacles, this is an offering that they're bringing to you. They are authentic, or they are genuine in their intentions towards you, but I feel that there is passion, lust, or desire that's lacking on your part, meaning they may not be typically what you physically go for when it comes to relationships for others of you. They may seem not as stable as you would want, but what they're saying here is that this person is definitely going to be making themselves very known, or letting you know that they're willing to go out of their way to prove to you. Basically, they're asking for an opportunity is what I'm hearing. So again, this person is not shying away. You may be dealing with an earth energy. It could be a Taurus, Capricorn, or Virgo. If it's a Taurus or a Virgo, I feel them more like more immature type of energy. So it could be that they're still trying to find themselves, meaning they may not be as financially stable as you would want. If you're dealing with the Capricorn type of energy, then this is definitely an individual that is more assertive. This is an individual that has, you know, very strong ideals, very strong, like they're really on their path towards financial stability. So that could be the reason why maybe you feel like you're a bit turned off because they're not really communicating as much as you would want them to, that type of energy. But again, if it is like an older type of energy, Capricorn type of energy, Saturn type of energy, it could be that they are actually busy. So again, don't jump to conclusions. Now, I do see a lot of communication happening with you guys. For some of you guys, it could be that boom, out of nowhere, in the middle of November, you hear from an ex, or an ex reaches out or tries to contact you, tries to communicate with you. Or this could be you, Leo, but I feel more like it has more to do with the person from your past that's trying to reach out to you. And it could be because they are actively watching either your social medias, they're hearing about you, or friends are talking to them about you, and that perhaps you moved on, or that you're doing your own thing. And there is a desire of wanting to revisit the past, but I feel that this has more to do with your ex or the ex-partner that you're no longer dealing with. What they're showing me here is, and I'm going to be very straightforward, there's going to be an opportunity that comes to you in the month of November with a new type of energy. Now, when I say new, if you're aware of the person that's trying to give you the attention, but you're not really feeling them, this is a different type of energy. This is a new type of energy. And what they're telling you is that, again, this could be a person that you meet either through friends, through some type of celebration, or they introduce you to, like a blind date type of thing. Take that opportunity, Leo. Don't sit there and be like, I don't want to do it. I'm not ready. I don't think I want to, because you're going to be not only surprised, but you're going to be thankful, because you have the Wheel of Fortune here and the Three of Cups. So it's not only going to be like an amazing time that you're going to have, but it's going to leave you guys wanting to spend more time together. And this is the beginning of something that is going to be flourishing in the future. So I would definitely take that opportunity. Now, for those of you guys that are in a long-term committed relationship, for some of you guys, especially those of you guys that have been or currently are engaged, I think it's time you start putting the pressure on your partner, because I see them like giving you the offering. Either they spoke about engagement, or you physically have the engagement ring, but it's been 2 years and they're not really making any movement. You need to speak up, Leo. And now is the time to do so. Why? Because it's important to not put pressure, but it's important for them to know exactly where you're at and what you're expecting from them. Now, this could be vice versa. It is a general reading. But again, what they're saying is you need to speak your mind, because if you don't, you know, 2-3 years down the line, you're still engaged. You're not married. So again, now is the time to really speak up. You know, don't hold back. Don't hold back or bite your tongue because you feel like, I don't want to hurt my partner's feelings. If their excuse is financial stability, yeah, I do see them working towards that, but it doesn't mean that they can't make it happen. You see what I'm saying? I just feel that they're comfortable. I feel that they don't really want to get out of that comfort zone, and it's necessary in order to get to the point of where you want to go, which is, you know, physically, that physical, you know, commitment towards each other. Now, this, like I said, it is a general reading. It doesn't have to connect with you on that sense. For some of you guys, it could just be that, you know, you're wanting to move in with your partner and they keep saying, you know, that they are currently dealing with financial difficulties. I don't see financial difficulties. I see that they are trying to save. But again, if you sit there and, you know, you become complacent, they're not really going to step up. So now is the time to really speak up. I hope that makes sense. All right, my lovelies, I hope that you guys enjoyed these readings. Like, share, and comment, and we'll see each other soon. Bye.